2D character controller. I got you. First, I recommend getting the new input system. I promise, you'll start liking it once you get used to it. Once that's done, make your guy. My guy's name's Guy. You want to give him a box collider, a rigid body, and a player input component. Give that guy an empty child, call it ground check, put the child on his feet. Now with the character done, let's make its home a bit less vacant. I'm going to make a ground object here, give it a box collider and a static rigid body. We should also make sure we give it a ground layer. You could just type it here and then select it. We can also make a few platforms, which is the same story, but I'm also going to add a platform effectors on it. This allows the player to jump through it from below, just like they do in a lot of platformers. Now that we got a nice looking setup, let's get started on the magic. In our project folder, let's make an input action asset, which should be at the bottom here. Give it a cool name and open it, and it should give us this. Here is where we will set up the controls. There's an abundant amount of things you can do with the input system, but we're just going to keep it simple today and make two controls, being movement and jumping. We'll make and name our action map, and then let's name our first action horizontal. Change the action type to value and change control type to axis. Now delete this default binding, click the plus and add a 1D axis composite. Rule of thumb with movement, negative is usually left and down, positive is right and up. So let's make the negative A and the positive D. We can also add more composites. If I duplicate this, I can make one for controller. All you gotta do is just make the path the left stick on gamepad. Make sure it's called gamepad and not a specific controller. After that, we can make a new action, call it jump. We can leave the action type as button. We can go here and make the binding space for keyboard. And for controller, make it button self, which is just A on an Xbox or X on a PlayStation. That's about as simple as you can get with controls, but you can go off here and add like 20 different spell attacks, but I'ma just save and exit this. Now as for the asset, we're just gonna open up a player, add him to the player input component, and there we go. Going into Visual Studio, you wanna make sure that you're referencing the input system like this. Set these three serialized or public variables and set these two private variables. Make sure that you reference the player input component from the start. Onto the movement, you can put this directly in the update method, but I prefer doing it in a separate function and calling them. It's just tidier. You want to write this to move the player based on the horizontal input that we set up earlier. And then this is an if statement that checks if you press jump. This makes whatever velocity value on Y zero, and then it adds a force below so it jumps. This alone will work, but the player will not change directions on where it's facing. This is where this part comes in. It will call upon the flip function when the player changes directions, and what that does, it will switch the facing right boolean and rotate the player. And that's why up here I get the absolute value, otherwise with this code the player would only go one direction. When saving and exiting the script after it all loads and hopefully no error messages pop up because you spelled triggered with 1G, we can set up these variables here. Set speed to whatever value, I'm going to do 6. Drag in your ground check object that you made in here. And as for the ground layer, select ground layer, the one that I told you to make at the start. After that, you should get a nice character controller to start with. But one small issue, and that is, we need something to keep him grounded. Let's go back into our code and add 3 more private variables. I promise these other two will make sense in a sec. Here, I made a function that does a few things. The first bit references the ground check kit that we conceived earlier and makes a circle collider on it. If they're touching the ground that we made, then it will make our grounded boolean true and our grounded timer 0.15, which we'll get to why that's important in a sec. This air timer condition is just to make sure that you can't do an exploit where you can double jump while spamming the button. So when jumping, we'll make it a value greater than 0 and then it will count down from there. This here will make it that if you have just slipped off a platform, you'll still be able to jump for a few split seconds. Trust me, this makes jumping feel much cleaner in the platformer. With all of that, we can go back to the jumping statement that we made in the movement function and add all of these so everything works. Also, don't forget to reference the grounded function in the update. Once that's all good, we can save and look at the progress we've made. It's looking pretty good. If you like this tutorial, show your boy some support and I'll try to pump out some more. Alright, have fun.